A reading of the Holy Gospel according to Luke. In those days, Mary set out to visit Elizabeth. After hearing her greeting, Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely from now on, all generations will call me blessed, for the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. God's mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arms. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. The Lord has helped his servant Israel, in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he had made our ancestors, to Abraham and to his descendants forever." Mary remained with Elizabeth about 3 months, then returned to her home.
Where there is darkness, let there be a light. In the dark of winter, that's what the birth of a Messiah is, the birth of Christ Jesus in the crib. On December 22nd, that's today, the winter solstice, that is the darkest day of the year. Really, it is the day when darkness covers the earth in a way that it only does on December 22nd. And it is actually no accident that Christmas is December 25th, 3 days later, when there is the ability to see just barely that the days are getting longer. Well, on this day of darkness, our hope is grounded not only in the birth of Christ, which is coming in 3 days, which will happen in 3 days, a mere 3 days, but we have Mary, his mother, who speaks to us from the gospel as the voice of one who knows she is favored. And therefore, so are we. She is the prophet of good news of salvation for the entire universe. That is the casting down of the mighty from their thrones and the rearranging of everything for the benefit of all of God's people. Mary is grounded in hope, and she knows her role in salvation as one who is truly blessed and privileged by God. She is the poor caveat to our salvation, the poor means to our salvation through her Son. And today, in this dark time, this dark day, this dark period, we rejoice with Mary's hope that our salvation is coming.